In this video, we are going to use this picture of a tree to figure out how to find more bugs in the software that you are trying to test. Imagine if I work for an old school organization and use test cases as something that guides my actions. But it's been a while since I found and reported any bugs. I will start questioning reality. Is something wrong with me? Am I a bad tester? The truth is, nothing is wrong with me. I just need to change the way I do testing. Simplest yet efficient way of finding more issues is doing things differently. Allow me to explain how test cases might be limiting you. Imagine you have a login page. And for this page, you have a test case that aims to check that login works. It might look like this, right? So you will see a lot of details of what you need to do and then some expected results. If you follow this directly as written, you might be missing a lot of possible test ideas. Let's transform this test to be leaner. Now, when it looks like this, how many new test ideas can you see? All I did is removed some details from the way we log in and how we enter login and password and also expected results. New options that I could see are logging in with another user, copy-pasting username or password, pressing login button with an enter key, accessibility checks like does the username input has a focus when the page renders or can you navigate with tabs, and many more. Now, I can go even further and convert this to a bullet point, like an item in the checklist. Something like this: check that you could log in with valid credentials. This allows me and you, who is watching this video, to use our human brains to make observations and generate new test ideas. That will allow us to have more variety in our testing and checking. This will ultimately lead to more bugs or features. If you're still not convinced with the concept, let me visually explain it to you with the help of this beautiful tree. It represents a vast amount of tests that you could perform in this area, so each branch and sub-branch is one test. When you add a lot of details to your test case, you create a specific pathway through this tree, like this one. As we discussed before, this narrow pathway will often be the only thing you check. That's how our human brains work. We want to conserve the energy and don't do the work which is not required. Okay, maybe you have 5, 10, 20 test cases in your company, but still, overall, the picture will look like this: a lot of narrow pathways through the tree. If your test has fewer details, look at the red line. Now, it's open to you and your interpretation to go and explore different variations of the same test. Remember that test case that we converted to be a bullet point? Here's how it would look if it was a tree. The red part is this minimal scaffolding description, and then the rest is open to interpretation. It allows us to improvise, come up with the ideas on the go, explore and find more subtle bugs that were hidden before. You could say, well, why can't we just create all these pathways as the test cases? So our tree is going to be more red. That is a valid question, but answer to it deserves its own video. Short answer is, it's impossible slash unsustainable to have so many. That's why I made an assumption earlier that in reality, it is very likely that you will just have 5, 10, 20 test scenarios. Now, you know the secret technique for finding more bugs. But if you struggle with generation of test ideas, watch this video, it will definitely help. See you next time.